Hello and welcome to the seedy underbelly of Los Santos for the first episode of Laurence Plays GTA 5 Manhunt. This is a new series on the channel that actually involves me playing with some other people. The series will revolve around the prey player who is trying to stay alive and the hunters who are trying to hunt the prey down and kill them. For this session we have two hunters plus myself as the prey. To make it a challenge, the prey doesn't get to use their map or radar, so I'll turn that off now since I forgot to do it before I started. I've got my viewpoint filling the screen for the video, and I'll add in a hunter view when they're near me so you can get an idea of what's going on with them. I'm also going to show the radar from the hunter's point of view in the top right, however rest assured that I can't see it when I'm running, that's just for your sake. So we've got me fleeing through the city with no radar so I can't tell where they are while they're following me, and they're using radar in order to try and hunt me down. Game ends when I get killed, and my objective is to try and survive for as long as possible. We're saying only bullet weapons and land vehicles for the moment, but you never know, that might change in a later game. But for now, I just have to run away as fast as I can and hope they don't find me. Well, they're going to find me eventually, because they've got the map they can use to narrow down, but I've got a reasonably good car. Hopefully they've not managed to find anything particularly good yet. And, yeah. And I have to try and avoid doing that as much as possible. we've got restrictions to bullet weapons. We've had a few ideas for weaponry beyond that. So, and we've eventually, after a bit of testing, we've decided that using single-shot weapons, if you're using a mouse to aim with, or using the submachine gun from inside the car if you're using a controller, because aiming with a controller is really difficult. And I think we've basically all decided that single shot weapons and... Oop, oh, goodness sake. Are better. The other thing that makes the game a bit more, should we say even, is that none of us are any good at it. As you can tell by how well I'm driving here. We're all sort of fairly low level in the game. We've not played a huge amount of it. We don't know the map very well. But hopefully that'll just add to the confusion and the excitement, so we all try and flee. And so far, well, I don't know. I don't know how close they are to me because I can't see them. But basically, I won't get any warning until I either get rammed or hear bullets ripping through the air and possibly through the car. So I suppose I probably really just want to keep going in a straight line, just try and keep as much distance between myself and them as possible. I want to not crash as much as possible. And yeah, just keep moving and maybe try and be reasonably unpredictable so they can't get in front of me and set up an ambush. I will see names over players if I get close enough, but in general that's not really... By the time I can see their names, they've probably already started shooting, so it won't help very much to be able to see that. It would also be quite interesting to see my track on the map afterwards, and work out how much I'm looping back on myself and how much I'm running away from them, and when I'm and how much of the time I'm spending driving directly towards them, because that's entirely possible. Because I've no idea where they are. And I'm driving not completely at random. I'm trying to go in sort of relatively... It's sort of cover as much ground as possible. So get across from one side of the city to the other. Ooh, that car was a bit... No, I don't think... It's not chasing me, so I don't think that was them. So I want to try and cover a decent amount of the city, because that, in theory, is going to keep me as far away from them as possible. But then I also don't want to be too predictable. I'm also not supposed to leave the city, so I think at this point I need to turn around and head back inwards again. And it doesn't matter too much with the game mode. It's not like I can... If I leave the city, they'll never find me, because obviously they've got the map to play with. But in an attempt to keep it sort of reasonably close and exciting, thought that... restricting things just to the city would be a good idea. I also want to turn my lights off, but I can't remember how to do that on a controller or on a keyboard. I think it's probably one of the D-pad buttons, but if I start pressing them at random, I'll just, I don't know, I'll probably fall out, jump out of the car or something. So I don't really want to start fiddling with things. I think I'm doing fairly well so far. This is longer than I've managed to evade them for before. We've tried various different ways of starting the game. This time it was a case of have them in, well, not them in my car, because I ended up with a two-seater. But the idea was to have for me to drop them off at some point, and they then had to find a car and start chasing. They're allowed to pick up any car they want, so they could well be behind me in a Coquette somewhere, or something else nice and fast. That said, I've got most of a Felon, which is pretty quick as well. So yeah, and they know what I'm in, or at least what I started in. So they'll know what they need to have something that can match. I'm surprised I've not seen anyone yet, actually. Normally by sort of a couple of minutes in, there's been at least a bit of a rattle of gunfire, even if they've not necessarily properly caught me. I obviously found a good place to drop them in, where there weren't any good cars available. There. Oh, there we go. They've spotted me. Run away. Oh, come on. Get going again. I heard a rattle of gunfire, but I didn't... Oh, that car looked like it wasn't being driven by an AI. Okay, the chase is on. I didn't even see what they were driving. I think it was red, but I'm honestly not sure. Oh, these smaller roads are better for losing people down, because they're more fiddly, but they take a bit more concentration to to follow. Oh! And if I do that, then it certainly doesn't help. Oh, that was awful. Still, I think I might have given them the slip. I mean, not really given them the slip, obviously, because they'll catch up with me as soon as they... well, they can always find me. But I don't see them at the moment. I think I've managed to get away from them a bit. Oh... Of course, if I hit too many other cars, that's not going to help me get away. I think I am now heading back roughly the way I came from, which is probably a bad idea, so let's go this way. Dodged one lamppost, or tried to dodge one lamppost, pinged off it straight into the second one. Look up here. I feel like this is going well so far. Although I've only got a rough idea where I am. I mean, I know this is the Life Invader building, but I don't know where that is. Let's go up here. This is actually quite scary. I've no idea where they are, how close they are behind me. They must be there somewhere. Because, well, they know where I am. They can't lose me. They just need to catch up and spray my car full of bullet holes. But hopefully, as long as I keep moving, make it a moving target, they'll struggle to get to where I am. So in theory, they've got one person driving and one person sort of navigating and shooting. Although the driver is welcome to shoot if they want, but it tends to be awkward to shoot when you're also trying to drive, especially at our skill level. So yeah, they've probably got a driver and a navigator and gunner. And the navigator will at least some of the time have their map open full screen, so they can tell where I've... They can always tell where I've gone. Maybe that hard turn... Oh. Okay, it's a different game where you can drive through the bus shelters. That hard loop around the bottom of that motorway ramp must have shaken them off, at least for long enough for me to get some distance, get distance down. Because I haven't seen them since. This is going pretty well, so I think. I mean, I know, that's famous last words and so on. I don't know how long I've been... Was that gunfire or was it just a car rattling? No, I think it's just the car rattling. Oh! That was a terrible indecision. I wasn't sure which way I wanted to go. I'm running out of city, though. I think I probably shouldn't go any further this way. Can I loop round and come back in? Oh, this is still pretty built up, actually. I think this is okay. I'll try and get a bit of a left in somewhere up here. And as I said, it's not the end of the world if I leave the city a little bit. Because, again, map, they can find me. But we're trying to keep the play area down a little bit. Was that an explosion? I think it was. Is there a way out of here? I don't want to go cross country in case I find myself in a lake or something. But I'm pretty sure I've just done a loop. At this point, I hope they are close to me and they have ending up having to follow me around that loop because I have no idea where I'm going. Oh no. This is looking like outskirts of the city again. Let's go. This is okay. This feels built up. Steer. There we go. Oh! That's one way to turn round, I suppose. So when I was saying I hope they're close behind me, turns out they were. Oh, this car isn't performing quite as well it was when I first got it. I think I've crashed it a few too many times. Oh, and they've got one of my front tyres, that's why. Oh no. I need to swap cars. But I don't know if I've got the distance to do it safely. I don't see anyone. But, I mean, if I'm going to swap cars, I need to swap something good. Well, that was... I don't know, is that a buffalo? I think it might have been. I daren't. I'm scared. Oh, they're shooting again. That's why I was scared. Oh, this is going to be another convenient turnaround, kind of. That sounded like another tyre going. I think I'm in trouble. Oh, no, 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 no. Oh, and another street lamp or two. I think the street lamps have done more damage to me than their shooting has. Can I keep the base of the car? Oh, no, there we go. Ah, he got me. Still, I don't think I did too badly. That was just under 14 minutes from me starting to run to death. I guess that gives me a target to beat next time. I hope you'll join me for that, but until then, thanks for watching.